You still only have 3 minutes, no matter how many people are there behind you.
Thank you. Good evening. My name is Brian McGivern. I'm here with you tonight as a member of St. David's Episcopal Church and a member of the leadership of Austin Interfaith. The people that you saw lined up at the back of the chamber earlier this evening are representative of the 30 institutions spread across this city and the more than 50,000 families that form our organization. In the past few months, the leaders of Austin Interfaith have held hundreds of conversations with our members and with our neighbors, in our communities, in our congregations, and in our schools, talking about the city budget. And what we have learned is that all of those people overwhelmingly support the investment in the people of Austin, in their livelihoods, in their children, and in their quality of life. Now I'm going to go through those one by one, but quickly. First, livelihoods. We encourage you to invest in the economic development programs that end the cycle of poverty. Pointedly, we request first that you transfer capital idea funding from the Health and Human Services budget to the Economic Growth and Redevelopment budget. Second, we also ask that you increase the capital idea funding to support recruitment and child care. Second, our children. Please reinvest in Austin's youth by restoring funding to youth programs. When funding was cut from prime time last year, many schools lost their after-school programs, including the one at Travis Heights Elementary, which is a member institution of Austin Interfaith. We ask that you reinvest in prime time. Further, we ask that you invest in summer youth employment. Every year it trains 1,400 young people, but can only employ about half of them. I think you'll all agree that anyone, if you care about public safety, investment in employment is probably the best investment that you can make. Finishing with quality of life, I'm going to mention parks and libraries. First, we have to prioritize funding to parks to make sure that they are safe and equitable. That means in order to maintain health and safety in Dove Springs parks, Austin's budget must include utility funding for lights and for water fountains, both of which are conspicuously absent from the parks in Dove Springs. It also means increasing resources for basic services, like the hours that a pool is open. What could be a more clear example of the divide between East Austin and West Austin than by having pools less available with fewer hours east of I-35? Finally, libraries. The effect of years of cuts to our libraries is showing in the graduation rates from our schools and our most vulnerable students. Without a solid base in literacy, the likelihood of delinquency and poverty increases. Thank you. We look forward to hearing from your offices to learn which of our proposals you'll support, and also which of you we can tell our members support their priorities, livelihood, their children, and quality of life. Thank you.
Councilmember Spellman.
Do you have a specific request, Mr. Giveron, with respect to libraries?
Yes, we do have a very specific request that I can follow up with you in more detail, but it includes hiring more bilingual librarians. I believe currently the budget includes money for two. We would request that you hire an additional four for a total of six.
Okay.
And I can get back to you with more detail.
I'd like to hear it. I think the rest of us would too. Thank you.
Absolutely. Thank you.
Kurt, Kadena Mitchell.